Hello, everyone. My name is Mohammed Khonizi. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about security of your website, and the anti-fraud. So just a little about me before I start going into the presentation. My background in security, I used to be an IT security consultant for over 3 years for Fortune 500 companies. I'm a certified ethical hacker. Don't worry, I'm not hacking anybody tonight. And I have a master's degree in information security. I'm most known for my website, Panda CashBack. This is our agenda for today. I will be talking, go through a short introduction, a little bit about the hacking techniques that being used in order to get into your website, whether it's a blog, whether it's an e-commerce, regardless of your role as an advertiser or publisher. Also, I'm going to go through the security life cycle. How does it really work in an enterprise or any security company? How do they really handle security for you? Some security tips to keep you on the safe side. Hopefully, you will not be hacked after that. No guarantees. Okay. I'll also go through the intrusion prevention system. It's more of a firewall for you if you want to implement it in order to make sure your website is still on board. I will go through also fraudulent chargebacks and how do you stay away from those. And finally, a recovery plan. I'm sure you have seen at least one of these companies at some point in the news. Unfortunately, they were not highlighting they made more money. They were just announcing they have been hacked. And just to put this in perspective, how bad being hacked looks like even for an enterprise, it looks really bad. It can reach up to $200 million for them, that attack. Target alone announced it costed them almost $200 million. Now, you may wonder and say, okay, it's a company like Target, it just makes sense why, you know, a hacker would want to attack these companies. But the truth is, every one of you is actually can be hacked. You are more of the prey that every hacker would actually want to go for you first, rather than go and spend his time on one of the enterprises. So according to Sophos Lab, it's one of the security companies, they estimated that 30,000 websites are being hacked on a daily basis. Well, definitely these are not enterprises because we don't see them on the news. And this number just growing up. The International Corporation mentioned that 71 of the websites that being actually breached are the small businesses. So this is just some of the famous techniques for being, you know, techniques that hackers usually use, like DDoS, cross-site scripting, and I'm pretty sure some of you are already familiar, stuff like spammers and scammers and, you know, bots. I'm not going to go through much these in details, but I'm going to give you a way to make sure you stay on the safe side. So some of the security tips. One thing I want to highlight, make sure before you implement any solution to create a website assessment. So I'm going to go give you some solutions today. Don't go and jump with one of the companies and implement it on your website because you may not really need that solution. Every website is unique and it have different needs. So keep that in mind. For sure, passwords and two-factor authentication. I'm pretty sure if you attended any security presentation or heard about security, everybody highlighting for you to go ahead and, you know, put 8 password characters, make it complicated. Well, sometimes it gets too complicated that you cannot remember it. So that's bad. So make sure if you are implementing passwords, at least categorize them. So if you have a, you know, in categories, like if I lost this, it's an easy, like let's say forums, you can put a common password for your forums. Just make sure you change this every few months. Your banking account, make sure you have a really complicated one that you can remember. You don't want to start putting your passwords on an app on your phone because this is how you actually provide a free access to hackers to get a bunch of your passwords together. Now, let's jump into the intrusion prevention and fraud detection. Now, it's a fact, all of you are the weakest, and me as well, you know, weakest link in security. Human beings always make mistakes. It's easy for me to pass by a table and see somebody writing their password. And, you know, there's a lot of social engineering stuff, but again, this is the thing that everybody focus on, and I'm pretty sure all of you have, to to some level, you know, heard of it. So as far as my only recommendation here, if you are having, you know, a password for a very important thing like your cPanel or your admin area, make sure to at least implement what you call it, two-factor authentications. And some of the companies I will highlight later on today offer this service even for free, where you can, you know, have one of these dongles moving around. So, you know, you are not logging that much. It will not be a bad idea. So the security lifecycle in any security department really looks like this. They always try to prepare, detect and analyze their traffic. If something goes wrong, if something doesn't seem suspicious, they as well, if things went really down and they have to contaminate the situation and start recovery. And finally, they create a post-incident activity. Now, this is just the high level for it. Now, this process actually gets repeated again and again. Now, I'm highlighting this only for one reason. If you are implementing a security system, you can go and buy a firewall script that you can put in your website. But if you cannot keep it up to date, you are in trouble. So some of the intrusion prevention solutions, and this sounds a little bit complicated, I mean really the firewalls. So if you are concerned about any of the hacking techniques I mentioned earlier, or even more, because actually 25% of the hackings that take place, people are not even familiar how did that hack take place. We just know the website got hacked. They would not really be able to highlight for you how did it get hacked. So it's still, there's a lot of unknown in it. So these are some of the companies that actually provide solutions, not only for enterprise, but even for small businesses. So Cloudflare, I'm sure maybe some of you have heard of it, some of the hosting company provided. Scaria, Encapsula, these are all companies that can provide you even a free service. So if the cost is an issue, if you have a blog and you're just starting, they actually provide you a free service. Now, that may change if you start implementing SSL and start accepting payment on your website. Now, this is just how they look. This is, I get it from Encapsula. And they really take the traffic that's coming into your website, it goes through them first, they filter it on multi-layers. If anything seems to be suspicious, they just make sure it does not go to your website. Okay. These are some of the actual services they provide. So they provide you a web application firewall, network firewall, the DDoS protection system in case they start getting unusual amount of traffic. They start making sure to expand your bandwidth so you don't get in, you know, trouble and get your website shut down. And again, every company provides different services. So if you would like to go and implement an intrusion prevention system, make sure you take a minute and compare which one would be more of a value to you. With this being said, one last step, there is, some of them actually offer more than security. So they make sure your website loads faster. And, you know, so there's some additional features that might be more important to some than the other. Now, fraudulent chargebacks are a serious issue, not only for advertisers, but as well for affiliates. I came once where I became in trouble as an affiliate for a chargeback happened to my advertiser. So 95 of these, according to FISA, are being targeting the small businesses. Now, there is many ways in order for you to detect the fraud, and there's a lot of companies who offer these services, and this is just some of them. You can, they do a fraud analysis and detection, they compare it with, you know, all of these issues that happen to different companies, whether it's big or small, they make sure it does not happen to you. So they actually create a huge database, collect emails, collect addresses, and every time somebody tries to sign up to your website, they will ping you this information against that database to make sure this guy have not tried to scam somebody else before. Okay. These are some of the companies that offer solutions, and surprisingly, some of them actually offer it for you for free. So if you are accepting payments, make sure you are protecting yourself from the chargeback. Don't rely on a company like PayPal, because guess what? PayPal does not provide you any protection for chargeback. They're actually going to penalize you if you ended up, you know, getting a chargeback. So some of them, like Fraud Lab, I guess up to 5,000 transactions for free, and after that, they're charging you really a small amount. Again, there is a difference between each one of these guys' services, what you want to, you know, make the verification for. Also, you want to make a balance. So in order for them to do this, they have to collect information. If you are not processing the payment, how much information, you know, can collect from the user? Sometimes an email verification might be sufficient. Sometimes a phone verification. So you will have to actually make that balance. Okay, if your recovery plan looks like this, you are in trouble. You never know when your website can go down. So make sure you have a good recovery plan. My advice, CodeGuard, I'm pretty sure you all have heard of it. It's nice to use it. It's really cheap. I guess it costs $5 per month, and if you have a shared service, even cheaper. But don't rely on it as your only backup solution, because guess what? You can still get in trouble. CodeGuard cannot guarantee for you a full recovery. However, they do a really nice job on, you know, page-by-page recovery. So my advice is you can go ahead with that and, you know, make sure you have at least another copy of your website somewhere else. And make sure it's not on your hosting, because they really cannot guarantee for you anything. Okay, so thank you very much. This is my information. If you have any question, and if even if you need any help with your web assessment, if you have a blog and you are not sure really how do you go from there, feel free to send me an email, or I'm around here for today. Feel free to stop me by and ask me any question you have. Thank you very much.